Coach, if the USFL were the stock market, the breakers have been trending downward while the rest of the South is headed north. Talk to me about yesterday's game.
Yeah, it was we struggled with getting any rhythm again this week. It was a tough game, hard-fought game. We had chances to win it. We just didn't. I don't think we stepped up when we needed to. And I thought our defense again played very well. And bend but don't break style of defense and took the ball away. And offensively, we just struggled to get into a rhythm all day long. And it was a lot of times it was just one guy. It was either an errant throw or a missed route or a protection issue. So we just got to tighten that up a little bit. We're still in first place. We have a big game on Saturday on a short week, so we better tighten it up.
Coach, it's funny because it seems like for the second straight week, the way to beat the breakers is just keep that high potent offense off the field.
I wouldn't call us high potent right now. We better get that out of our brains and get back to work. And so that's all I know how to do. That's all our players know how to do. And if you love football, that's all you know how to do is just get back to work and find a way and be a part of the solution and not part of the problem. So that's what we're trying to do here today as a coaching staff. Players have off today, and we're problem solvers, not problem creators.
You mentioned the play of the defense. They have really stepped up the last 2 weeks. I mean, and they have done the main thing that any coach or any fan wants when seeing their team play. They've created turnovers and gotten the ball back in the offensive hand.
They have. They've done a great job. And we hope we all hope as a team that the defense continues to do that. And that's a huge part of the game is obviously stopping the other team from getting points. So the defense has been playing very well.
Let me ask you about McLeod Bethel-Thompson, obviously the league's leading passer. Last 2 weeks doesn't seem as sharp. Listen, he's coming off a Grey Cup winning season with the Toronto Argonauts in the CFL. He hasn't looked as fresh. Is this a case perhaps maybe just a long extended season?
It's funny you bring that up. I have not talked to him about that, but I can see that's a good question. I have not talked to him about that just because our sole focus is on this team. And, but that's, he and I talked this morning about a few other things, going about moving forward. And it's not brought up. He has not moved. I don't think he's tired by any means. We missed a couple throws we needed to make yesterday. And that happens, unfortunately, sometimes.
Are there any plays looking back? I'm assuming you had a chance to look at the tape.
I have, yes, twice.
Are there any plays, any calls that you'd like to have back?
Always. There's always calls like that back. There's certain times I would have thrown it yesterday. There's certain times I would have run it yesterday more. And there's always certain calls you wish you had back. And so that's every game. Not just even games you win, you're like, man, the quarterback bailed me out there or the receiver bailed me out there. Wow, the O-line really blocked that play up, that run up well when that was mistimed. You always have those plays in every single game.
When I think about your career, it's a long one, especially as an offensive coordinator in the NFL, obviously quarterbacks coach for the Eagles during the Super Bowl run. Quarterback James Madison, I mean, your father, you're from football. I mean, it's in your blood. During your career, whether it be playing or coaching, have you ever had as many games come down to the wire each and every week? I think other than the a big game, I'm losing it now. I think the 45-31 win in week three, week four, I believe. Have you guys had as many close calls as it has been?
I have not. In the NFL, a lot of times, a lot of years, you have a lot of one-score games, and a lot of teams, when you look at team success in professional football, is really how they do in one-score games. And so a lot of these games are going to be tight. And we just got to be the last guy to make the big play. And like I said, we just got to get back to being us and who we are.
But, Coach, it seems like every single week, every single week, is coming down to the final drive. And even we can go towards the half even before the half each week, it seems like there's a big play, a big decision, a big third or fourth down every single week.
Yeah, it's pro football for you, baby. And that's pro football for you. That's why everyone loves it.
Now, I'm not going to get you in trouble right now, but I want to talk to you about that interception late in the game, which I think they reversed. You were talking to the referees on the sideline. Talk to me about what you were telling them, what you saw.
On the interception on our sideline?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I was just trying to see, you know, what Pereira was seeing, you know, and I was watching on the big screen, you know, up there on the big screen, and it sure looked like our feet were in and the quarterback's feet were in when he threw it. And so I was just trying to get a rule and making sure that, you know, that obviously got ruled correctly, and they did a nice job of ruling that up.
You said early in the season, you said that, listen, with winning, every game becomes more and more important. Do you guys feel that there is a target on the Breakers back each week because you're getting the best of everyone?
I don't know about that. You know, this is pro football. I mean, if you don't show up, you're going to get blown out by anybody. So, yeah, do I think teams take – yeah, I mean, early on we were 4-0. I think naturally you have a target on your back for sure. And I talked to our players about that. And that, with that comes responsibility. And so, we're not going to press the panic button by any means. It's not the first time a professional football team's lost two games in a row. We don't like it. We're not happy. But at the same time, we still have everything in front of us, and we're still first place in our division.
Well, I'll tell you, this week, it doesn't get any bigger than the South Division rival, Birmingham Stallions. And, of course, you guys, I think you're now 7-2 lifetime against Birmingham if we go back to the original league. And, of course, this week, it's a big game. Talk to me about what the team needs to do to get back on track and against the defending champions.
Yeah, I just think, you know, first off, offensively, we need to get some rhythm. You know, we need to get some rhythm. If the defense does create turnovers for us, like we're expecting them to do, capitalize off those turnovers. Capitalize off of making sure that, hey, when the ball gets out on a nice kickoff return, we capitalize on that field position. The other thing I want to see us do is not do stupid penalties. The taunting penalty killed us yesterday. It absolutely it killed us. We're across the 40. Going to take the lead, and now you're backed up and all those things. So that play really hurt. We had 12 penalties. I think they had 13. But there's good penalties are going to happen in a game. You're going to false start. You're going to hold every once in a while. But the ones we can avoid, we have to avoid because we just have to. You can't taunt people. And that was taunting. It was a right call.